President Marcos says he is open to revert the school break to its old calendar. In a radio interview, Marcos said government would study the proposal carefully and consider other factors like COVID cases and changes in the weather. Senate Committee on Basic Education Chairman Senator Sherwin Gatchalian earlier said schools should go back to a June to March academic calendar, allowing students to have a break during the scorching summer months. The president's remark comes as the searing heat forces some schools in the Philippines to suspend in-person classes. Reports say students are getting ill because of the hot weather. The Education Department says it's now up to school heads to decide if they will continue holding face-to-face classes given the soaring temperatures.
Kahit saan po sa Pilipinas, basta po sa ating mga public schools, ang ating mga school heads ay meron pong discretion at authority na magsuspindi ng in-person classes at lumipat sa tinatawag nating alternative delivery modes kung sakaling napakainit po sa ating mga paaralan dahil ayaw naman nating makaapekto sa kalusugan ng mga bata at pati na rin ng ating mga teaching and non-teaching personnel yung init ng panahon.
The Teachers Dignity Coalition, meanwhile, says the DepEd's directive can become a source of confusion. The group also calls for long-term solutions to education problems linked to the weather.
Kung ibibigay natin doon sa discretion ng school head, specific po yan, school heads, principals,
yes.
Ibig sabihin.
Yes.
Ano po, maaaring mag-vary no, kung paano nila ini-interpret at kung paano i-implement. Strategic dapat yung approach po natin dito.
Yeah.
Kasi sa totoong buhay, yung dinidiscuss natin, ano, heat index, yung storm warning signal, hindi pa pwede na from time to time, pag lumakas ang ulan, wala na tayong pasok. Pag uminit, wala na tayong pasok, di ba? Dapat i-confront po natin ito. Dapat for classrooms, hiring for teachers, maayos na ventilation, of course, no, lower class size, no? And kung kaya natin, bakit hindi natin bigyan ng aircon, no, yung ating mga classrooms?
The Philippines and China seeking to establish more lines of communication to resolve any issues in the West Philippine Sea. That statement coming from Philippine President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. following his meeting with Chinese State Councilor and Foreign Minister Chin Jiang in Malacañang. Marcos hailed the three-day visit of the Chinese official as very useful. He said Filipino and Chinese officials were able to iron out several miscommunications between the two parties. Chin's visit comes days after Chinese ambassador to the Philippines, Wang Shilian, drew public ire over his perceived threat against overseas Filipino workers in Taiwan. Meanwhile, Manila and Beijing pledged to improve bilateral ties and trade relations during Xinjiang's meeting with Philippine Foreign Affairs Chief Enrique Manalo. The areas of cooperation agreed on by the two countries include agriculture, infrastructure, science and technology, tourism, as well as academic and labor exchange.
I hope that today's meeting will give us an opportunity to follow through on the plans and gains made for our country's recent high-level interactions and make some headway in addressing common issues and challenges.
China is ready to work with the Philippines to truly implement the consensus between the presidents of our two countries, keep to the direction of friendship between our two countries, jointly uphold the larger picture of our bilateral relationship.